We'll now get back to Mr. Festus Okoye, the commissioner, INEC commissioner in charge of the Anambra governorship election tomorrow. Sorry for that technical hitch the other time. Mr. Festus, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining us on Plus TV News Now. I had to hold myself back on that report from bursting into laughter when I heard one of the respondents saying, "We don't want katakata tomorrow." He says, "We don't want katakata." Can you imagine? So it shows that there is palpable fear in the atmosphere in Anambra. I mean, what do you make of this? Just less than 24 hours to the citizens exercising the franchise, they are full of fear. What's going on?
Well, from my own impression, from the impression I gathered going around some of the local governments, from my interaction with our ad hoc staff, from my interaction with some of the voters, and also some of the critical stakeholders, the impression I get is that people are enthusiastic, they are desirous, they want to come out and exercise their democratic franchise. But as you pointed out, there are concerns around the issue of security. There are issues around fear. Some people are slightly terrified at some of the issues or some of the things that have happened in the past. But as you can see, in the past 1 week, things have simmered and things are calm. The security agencies are all over the place. They are dominating the electoral space and the electoral environment. And they have assured the voters, the ad hoc staff, the journalists, domestic and international election observers of their safety and their protection. People are generally enthusiastic about this election. When I went around with the chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, to some of the local governments, you can see that people came out en masse, especially the new registrants, to come and collect their permanent voters' cards. And at our INEC offices today, you can see the whole place is buzzing with activity because the locus of activity has shifted to the various local governments and also the various registration area centers. So things are shaping up, and we believe that the people of Anambra will troop out tomorrow to come and exercise their democratic franchise.
Mr. Okoye, you've spoken very well. You've spoken well. We've listened to you. But before we heard you, we also heard the people. And we saw the environment. It's scanty, despite the withdrawal of the sit-at-home order by IPOB. Why is Anambra metropolis still looking so scanty?
Well, it's because it's Anambra metropolis. On election day, most people who live in the metropolis tend to go back to their various local governments where they register to go and cast their votes. I went to Dunukofia local government today. I went to Njikoka local government today. And I also was in Awka South local government today. And in all these places, you could see activities bustling. And people were generally going about their normal businesses. People were in the market. People were in the filling stations. People were just going about their normal businesses, and people are also looking up to tomorrow for it to come so that they can exercise their democratic franchise. Yes, it is true that if you look around Awka itself, the metropolis, you will see a scanty movement. But the moment you step out a little bit to other local governments, you can see that people are going about their normal activities, and nothing is amiss. People are generally looking forward to tomorrow.
Okay, you're looking forward to tomorrow's election. We're looking forward to tomorrow's election as well. Everybody is interested in what happens in Anambra tomorrow for obvious reasons. Now, do you suspect voter apathy?
You know, I really wish I have the capacity to see tomorrow. I really wish I've been endowed with that particular power. But, you know, it seems to me that the people of Anambra realize the importance of this particular election. They know that this is what we call an end of tenure election. The incumbent governor has served for two terms, and we step out, and the new face will take over the mantle of governance in Anambra State. They realize this particular fact. Secondly, they also realize the fact that if something goes wrong and they're unable to exercise their democratic franchise, that the issue of who becomes the governor of Anambra State or who takes over the governance of Anambra State slips out of their domain, slips out of their hand, and is now in the domain of somebody else or a different entity or a different agency of government. And they realize that. Third, they realize that this election is about their own future, about the future of their own children, and they fully understand this. And they also fully understand the fact that these are very unusual circumstances in terms of the sheer number of security personnel that have been deployed to Anambra State for the purposes of maintaining peace and security in this election. And I believe that the people will want a situation where they can return to their normal lives, return to their normal businesses, and also have a stable relationship in terms of their daily activities and their daily businesses. So they know the importance of this particular election, and I'm confident that the people will come out tomorrow to exercise their democratic franchise. Whether we are going to have a high turnout or low turnout is just left for the people of Anambra State to decide. The ball is in their court, and the decision time is tomorrow.
Thank you, Mr. Fessin. Let's wrap this up. Let's wrap it up. In less than 30 seconds, bring us up to speed on your preparedness. You sound really excited and enthusiastic about the outing tomorrow. Bring us up to speed about your preparedness for tomorrow's outing.
Well, we are ready for the election. 2 weeks ago, we deployed all the non-sensitive materials to all the local government areas. Yesterday, we deployed the sensitive materials, and also we deployed the beavers to the local governments. When I went around some of the local governments, they had already started moving to the registration area centers, ready for deployment to the various polling units tomorrow. So we are ready as an electoral management body. There were a few hitches here and there, but we have our plan B on addressing any issue that may likely arise. So our message to the people of Anambra State is that they should go out and exercise their democratic franchise, and their votes will be the only determinant of who governs them come March 2022.
Well done, Mr. Festus. Thank you very much, Mr. Festus, for joining us on Plus TV News Now. We wish you
Thank you so much.
In your outing tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.